Hey guys, Dark Rain here. Welcome back to Let's Play H1Z1. This is episode 11, I think, and we're back, you know, doing stuff. So, I added a little bit of stuff to my base since last time I talked to you guys. So, in this room right here, I got like a little B-box and a crate. This is a drop-off shack. So basically, if I come to the base and I need to drop off stuff real quick and then get back out, I can just drop it in there and then go back out the gate. Yeah, that's pretty much it. I added like sleeping mats to all the doors to protect them a little bit more from explosives. Last time I did an episode, I had a quad like right here in a Jeep, but someone blew up our Jeep and our quad, and I found a new quad today, so yeah. But today we're not gonna be using a quad. We're just gonna be doing like my normal loot runs. I'm gonna kind of show you guys what I normally go through. This is just type of things that you kind of need to do to progress in the game, which is loot runs. So, the loot runs I do are pretty small, and they're tailored for specific items like water bottles and a little bit of ammo, but stuff like that. So sugar, sugar and water bottles are good for like making ethanol. I'm not sure if there's anyone out here. I don't know. Earlier I was playing with a mega group, like a group of like at least 7 guys. We were having a good old time rolling around the map killing people. It was fun. I actually have a pretty funny clip of everyone was like fucking with this bear, and we were trying to kill it with our fists, or at least my friends were, because the freaking bear attacked me and I was down to like 25% health. I'm trying to bandage and they keep fucking with the bear, and they basically punched the bear to death. And the last person to punch it, like, uppercutted it, and it freaking flew up in the sky. It's pretty cool. I think I might throw that clip in here just to show you guys what I'm talking about. But, yeah, I thought that was just, you know, pretty funny. I finally figured out how to use Shadow Play on PC. So you can do, like, on Xbox One, you just say Xbox record that. And it, you know, records, like, a 30-second clip. Or it records past 30 seconds. And for the PC, it's kind of like that, except it records the last 5. So. Oh, that's pretty cool. I'm very happy with my new computer. Super ecstatic. Like, ah. I love it. Oh, yeah, so, I watched my last video, and you can hear the click-clack on my keyboard, and I'm not gonna be able to fix that till, like, probably in the next episode. I need to basically, like, tear apart my little gaming setup and, put my old keyboard back in here, so I will do that next time, so you guys don't have to hear clacking of my keys. But yeah, I don't know. I kind of like it because, like, when you're doing something, like boop, 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 and like, you know, I don't know, I just feel like with a mechanical keyboard, everything just feels more pronounced when you hit like a key. That's my personal preference, but I'll change it for you guys because I know you probably don't want to hear clicking when you can see me doing the thing that the key is meant to do. So yeah. So basically, I just lit up this office, or like, it's like a gas station rest stop area. I do the restaurant, then this convenience store, and then this gas station. This gas station's kind of tricky. You gotta crouch down, get the ammo out of these lockers, or filing cabinets, whatever. If you have a melee, you can break through this little piece of wood right here and get into the back office. There you go. So I'm just gonna walk in backwards as I do this. Do I not have any shoes on? I don't have any shoes on again. This is starting to set a trend. So you kind of have to, like, walk in here backwards. There we go, you got it. But, yeah, I don't know why I don't have shoes on. I had them on before I logged off. I guess they might have decayed or something. I don't fucking know. Sometimes I find fertilizer over here. Yeah, fertilizer right there. Fertilizer is used for, like, obviously fertilizing your crops. And you can also use it to make IEDs. Or as we say, IEDs. We say it kind of like a fucking Forrest Gump from, Forrest Gump. So, yeah. It's just like a running joke that we have. Whenever we go to raids, like, you got any IEDs? And everyone knows exactly what he's talking about. So, this guy over here, you see this small little shack. He is building this base right here. And that's a big no-no because this entire area is ours. We kind of claimed it, you know. It's like an unspoken rule. And the guy decided to build right there, so he blew down his shack, took all of his stuff, and, yeah, basically made him quit the game. I know that sounds mean-spirited, but I mean, like, come on. Like, you see, like, all these bases around here. Why would you think that you can put yours over there? I don't know. Maybe the guy has a different thought process, but in my head, that's wrong. You don't do that shit to people. So, anyways, we're gonna drop off this little bit of loot that we have. Not very much, but I'd like to collect some more locker keys, and then I will, go to the hospital and go collect those, but the last time we went, we turned in like 80 locker keys, so we turned in pretty much every locker key we had. So right now I think we've only got it like 20 maybe. And I want to take like a considerable amount up there if I'm going to do it. So till next time. Why am I carrying ethanol on me? I thought, oh yeah, cuz I was planning on going to the hospital, and then I realized we didn't have very many keys, so I decided I'd just do my normal loot runs and show you guys what I do. Show you the life. Put all this ammo in here, and this food, and we'll actually get care of that food, the rocket keys. You might be asking why I'm picking up all these crowbars and wrenches, and I normally just smelt them down and make bars, and then I use the bars to make like certain things. Like we got so many bases that I like to take on a new project every now and then. So like once we got this base completely done, including the farm, we did that fire station base that I showed you guys last time or last episode. And it's just little things like that I like to add on to. Oh, so one of our friends thought it'd be funny to put a giant cock outside our base. So yeah, we have a penis outside our base. It's spewing cum onto the street. Very nice. Very, very nice. So right now we're going to go over to LJ's. Normally when I'm over here, I get like some axes and water bottles and stuff. So, yeah. All good stuff. If I can pick this bitch up. Smelt down these axes. Sometimes there's fertilizer, yeah. More fertilizer. What? 2 fertilizer. That's what's up. I like that. Can of food, maybe a water bottle, all good stuff. But yeah, looting's a really basic part of H1Z1. It's just, you know, things you need to do to progress in the game. And I like looting, honestly. Like, most people are like, oh, fuck looting, like, that's boring as shit. But I don't know, I kind of like the grind, honestly. I don't know what it is, I just like grinding. And that's not to say the same thing for, like, every other game. Dalton makes this argument with me all the time, because Dalton and Johnny are, like, super into Destiny. And I played with them, you know, I'm like level 40 on my Titan character, and like I've played with them, but it's, I don't get into the game as much as they have, like not even close to as much as they have. But they always make the argument that I could play Destiny the way I play H1Z1, and I don't know, it's just, I like survival MMOs, like I like survival MMORPGs, that's like my thing. And Destiny is more of like, the grind in Destiny is more for, like, levels and gear and, like, things to even buy gear or things to upgrade gear, like, stuff like that. So, I could get into that, and I mean, I have. When I play Destiny, I don't like to grind by myself. I like to play, like, Dalton or Johnny, so we have, like, a good time. Because, you know, fuck, why play video games if you're not going to have a good time, right? So, yeah, whenever I go to play Destiny, I make sure I have somebody to play with, because, I don't know, it doesn't feel fun when you're not playing with other people. On H1Z1, that's a different story. Like, I like playing with, like, big groups and stuff. That's always fun. But I also like just looting by myself, because I can, like, turn on a podcast, and just kind of chill out and, like, play the game and fucking, you know, watch TV, music, whatever. That's what I like about H1Z1, is because I can do all those things while still playing the game and progressing. It's not, like, a game that you need to be paying attention to, like, 100%. Like, I could be doing these loot runs and talking to you guys, or be doing these loot runs and watch TV, so, yeah. So we did LJ's, now we're gonna go, normally when I do this run, I do the fire station first, but I thought I'd leave that out because, I think someone was just in here before I logged on. So, yeah. So, this is one thing. If you guys would like to see me fucking live stream this game, just let me know, because that's actually, like, a thing I can do now, so. That'd be fun. You guys would be able to see me play with my crew. I don't know. We're a wild-ass bunch. Like, everyone in the crew that I play with is pretty crazy. like, a lot of, like, Scott and Kyle haven't been playing the rest of this wipe because they kind of got, I don't know, they just got bored of the game. And I can see why, because this wipe hasn't been very eventful. But, I heard noises. So cool. Okay, sorry guys. I thought I heard fucking footsteps. You just gotta be careful, because I hate looting these lockers, because I feel like my back has turned, and it is, and someone could just come up and shoot me. Like, I can't tell you how many times I've been sitting in the fire station base and saw that someone ran in here, and I just come up and shoot them in the back of the head and take all their gear. Like, that's happened so many times I can't even count it. Or count it. Oh well. So this base is still not going to decay because some retard decided to claim it and then freaking repair it. So now it's going to take like another week or two to decay. So, Mark went around and repaired all the bases, like my friend Kyle's base and my friend Scott's base, because they haven't been on. So, it's just a courtesy thing to do, because you know, like they'd do it for us if we weren't playing. So, I don't know, just a nice thing to do. All right, drop off my shit. I'm gonna shred that backpack and the shirt as well. The only backpacks to keep are these tan military ones. These ones I shred, and the shirt I'll shred. Make bandages later. Okay, so now we're gonna go to Romero's. That's normally the third thing that I do. So this run is pretty basic. Like I'm not saying that like if you're playing H1Z1 this is the best run to do, but this is just a run that I do every now and then, like just to, you know, to do something productive. And like I said, it's tailored towards getting, like, ammo and, like, gear. Like, you know, excuse me. Oh, God, I have, like, this terrible fucking, like, I had tacos, and they were super good, but, like, I put way too much fucking hot sauce. Now I feel like I can, like, taste it. Anyways, what was I saying? Something about fucking things. Oh, my God, totally forgot what the fuck I was saying. Oh yeah, this run. So this run is tailored more towards like ammo, I guess gear, and like water bottles, food, metal. And by metal, I mean like taking those like axes and crowbars and wrenches and smelting them down to metal bars. That's basically what this run is for. And the fire station, since this is like my home, I can just kind of go in the fire station whenever I want. Like I don't have to like make sure I don't get killed or shot or anything. I just waltz in there because it's my place. So. I'm really happy that's a thing that I have, because in previous wipes, I've never built, or I haven't been in PB. I kind of took, like, we took over Cranberry once, took over Ranchito once, and we took over, like, a small town. It's not even a town, it's a rest stop called Crescent Reach, and we took that one over for a long time. Like, that was just our place for a while. And then they nerfed ammo, and they kind of fucked up spawns, so it became harder and harder to live out there without a vehicle. So we eventually moved to different cities, but... Anyways, being in PV is just such a luxury. Like, everything, anything and everything you can, like, think of or want is here. You don't really need to go far for anything. That's what I like about it. Because, like, when I get killed in PV, I know if I get a D5 spawn, I can get a gun and walk over to whoever just killed me and kill them before they even know what's happening. Like, it's that amazing. But, it's, you know, it's just the chances of getting a D5 spawn, though. Because that's kind of a rare spawn. But, I don't know, I get it normally when I need it. Like, sometimes I can't get it for the life of me, but other times I just get it at a random. So, yeah. And if you guys don't know what I mean by spawns, if you die, you can type in /respawn when you, like, respawn somewhere else on the map. And /respawn will kill you, basically, and then you respawn somewhere else on the map. And, you're trying to get these positions on the map. I don't have a map on me. But, the map is, like, scored up into different sectors. So it'd be, like, A1 to J10 or something like that, and it's just like these little sectors, and you know, everyone's like, oh, I'm in like D5, which is Pleasant Valley, or I'm in F3, which is over by Vehicle Road. Like I don't know, it's like a H1Z1 lingo that everybody kind of knows. So it's hard, I guess it's hard to explain, but I don't know. Well, I don't really know how to explain it better than that. Without pulling up a map or anything. Which I don't have. Normally I have a map on me. I don't know why I carry it around, though. I've been playing this game since it came out. I know every inch of the map. Literally every inch. Like, there's probably nothing you could tell me that I don't know about this game. Which is kind of sad, because I have 1,862 hours on this game. That's not including what I have on my alt characters. Like, my banker and my other character. So, yeah. It's ammo. Alright, so this run... Oh, did I check this? Yeah, okay. So this run's pretty much complete. Romero's is like the last thing I do. I could add a little bit to this run that I've never done before. Oh, actually, I'm full. I'm gonna add a new part to this run. Is there a medkit down there? Oh, that's how you know no one's been here. Medkits will spawn on these shelves in the pharmacy of Romero's. And that's how you know nobody's around, because everybody picks those up. Anyways... I'm gonna add a new part to this run, so as soon as I go out of Romero's and I take a right, there's gonna be like another like shopping center, and I'm gonna go loot that up. I'm gonna see what I can get. I never do that because it's really close to these bases that I don't know who lives there. I'm not friendly with them, so I could get shot. But either way, we'll try it. I still don't have shoes. What the fuck is wrong with me? I think I'm gonna get a pair of shoes. I'm gonna devalue my morals just to get a pair of shoes, because I do not like freaking walking this slow. It's painful. Very, very, very painful. Oh, so you guys would not believe the fucking trouble I had trying to upload the last video. So, episode 10, I had a good time making it. I was like, yeah, we're back, you know, stuff and things. And, done recording the video, I got the audio all compressed and noise canceled and blah, 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 all set up. And, I'm recording on my main PC, and I'm recording the audio on my second computer, which is where I render the videos and edit them and stuff like that. So I need to get the file over to my other computer. And you think, like, oh, you just get, like, a thumb drive, put it on there, and then put it in the other computer and upload it. Not that simple, because for some reason, the file would not go onto the flash drive. It would not go onto it, even though the flash drive was empty. So, after, like, 3 days of trying to figure out how to do it and trying several different methods, it didn't really work quite well. I was talking to my buddy Mark about this problem, and he's like, oh, yeah, man, all you gotta do is this, this, and that. I'm like, no, you don't. Like, don't fucking lie to me. Like, you're just gonna waste my time. And for those of you who don't know, my buddy Mark is a network engineer, and he knows a fuck ton about computers, like, a lot of, like, in-depth things, like networking and stuff like that. So he basically explains to me how to reformat the flash drive so it can contain files that are bigger than, like, 10 gigabytes or something like that. It's called, like, a fat EXE or something. But yeah, he helped me out with my problem, and I was like, dear God, you're a genius. I'm, like, very thankful that he helped me out with that shit, because that would have took me years of Googling, or I never would have figured it out and had to scratch that episode, and I would not be recording this current episode. So, special thanks to Mark, because he's very nice and cool and stuff and things. So, yeah. I didn't grab a pair of shoes. Oh, my God. This is just disgusting. My feet are probably all bloody, and they have, like, rocks and thorns and, like, deer shit stuck in between them. Ugh. It's terrible. Just gonna fucking get up here and go get some shoes real quick. I think we have a couple pairs in here somewhere, maybe? I don't know, we gave out a bunch of shoes today. Nope, no shoes in there. Shoes in here? Are you kidding me? Are you fucking kidding me? I don't see any. I'll take even regular shoes. Oh, there's some combis. Yeah. Okay. Yeah, so one of the guys that I play with, he skinned this 308 for me. I don't know if you guys can see it properly, but it's graffiti, and it looks really cool. Like, I love it a lot. I wish I had that skin. The only skins I have for guns are, like, the combat shotgun, which is what I have on right now. It makes the shotgun look cleaner. And I also have the Showdown AR-15 skin. That one looks pretty cool, but the Graffiti 308, like, ah, it's just such beautiful camo. Or skin, whatever you want to call it. So, today we were killing people, and we did a big run to, like, the dam, then the cranberry, and then looped back, and we had a couple kills, like, I think, like, maybe one or two kills, like, not very many. Actually, you know what, in cranberry, we were all in, like, the middle of cranberry, and there's, like, a little parking lot. About, like, I think it's, like, east? No, if I was standing there, it'd be north. It was north of the, police station, and we're standing in this parking lot. We see two guys, and there's, like, was it a car? Okay, never mind. There's, like, three of us, and there's technically seven of us, but everyone was kind of behind. It was just me, Mark, and some other guy, and we all see him, so we all shoot, and the guy next to me, he hits the first guy on the right, and I hit the second guy on the left, and the first guy, on the right, some guy killed, I don't remember his name. I guess he's my friend, I don't know. So the first guy on the right drops, and then the other guy goes to run, and I shot him once in the chest, and I took off his tac armor, and then Mark just domes him, like, straight up just headshots him and fucking kills him. And they had a fuck ton of loot. Like, they had an insane amount of loot to be walking around, so that was cool. And then on our way back, we're like, I think it's like G5, we're at the cabins, and we're like, oh, well, it was kind of a depressing trip, we didn't get very much gear, blah, blah, blah. Well, besides the guys that we killed. So we're like, oh, it's fine, we'll just walk back. And we're on our way back, and they're like, hey, dude, there's a quad coming your way. And I was a little bit behind them because I didn't have shoes, and I was, like, freaking panting like a motherfucker. Like, I had, like, zero stamina. And so I'm, like, a couple feet behind them, and they start, like, lighting up this quad, like, this guy in this quad. And they hit him a couple times, but he was still driving. And I don't know what it was, but I just fucking saw him with my 308, and I aimed a little bit in front of him and shot him, like, headshot, just dropped him. And we got a quad, so that was cool. Oh, what's up, dear? You better fucking run. So, yeah, that was fun. See, things like that just make you want to keep playing this game like that. That's just addictive. When you kill someone like that, it's especially in that type of way, it's just, it's like such a confidence booster. You're like, damn. Like, if I could do that every fucking time I PvP, I'd be the Lord. A lot of people play, like, King of the Kill, which is the BR version of H1Z1, to get their PvP skills up. And I've done it a couple times, but, like, I don't know. My PvP skills are not, like, insanely good, but not insanely bad. Like, I'd say I'm, like, average PC player. My friend Mark is really good. Like, there's fucking legends surrounding this fucking guy. Like, no joke. He's really good at PvPing. Every now and then, he'll get killed by some noob or something like that, but that happens to everybody. But yeah, he's an exceptionally good player. I'd say he's above average. Like, if I came across a group of four, I'd probably die. Like, I'd probably take one, maybe two out. My buddy Mark could clutch that. He could kill every single one of them, take all their gear, and laugh at them. Like, that's just the type of guy that he is. So, it's always cool to have him on my team. I've been playing with him for, like, almost a year now, so. Oh. People like that are, like, they're like unicorns. Like, you gotta find them and snatch them up and stick them in your basement and never tell anyone about them. So, yeah. Well, we're about, like, 21 minutes into the episode. I think we're gonna go back in the base and sort out a bit of this stuff and then end off the episode. So, this is just, like, my normal loot run. I think next episode I should have enough keys to go to the hospital. And we'll do that. I'm really excited to be recording games on my PC. If you guys have any suggestions of, like, what games I should play on PC, let me know. I've been thinking about doing, like, modded zombies, modded Minecraft, stuff like that. Like, a lot of mods, because those extend the life of the game and make them funner. Okay, so we got all this organized out. We're just going to take the ammo out of here, because I don't want that sitting in the front. What else could we take that's important? Animal fat. Oh, that fertilizer, we gotta take that. Take the med kit. I saw ethanol? Key. And we also wanna take sugar. And these bottles. We'll go sort this out in the back room. I'm kinda tempted to take my quad and stash it in the woods, because we cannot keep a quad for some reason. Someone keeps coming and blowing up our shit, and it's really starting to piss me off. It's to the point where, like, I just, like, it's such a motivational killer when you get on. You're like, hey, let's go do this and that. And we're like, oh, we don't have a car. And it's like, oh, well, fuck. Then we can't go do those stuff and things that we wanted to do. So, yeah, motivation killer. But that's alright. I'm a persistent motherfucker. If I want something, I get it. Especially in H1Z1. Alright, we're gonna drop all this shit off. Animal fat comes with me. So. Yeah, I hope you guys enjoyed this episode of Let's Play H1Z1. If you liked it, then like the video. If you want to comment, then comment. And yeah, see you guys in the next episode. Bye-bye!